Good morning, all of you. Thank you so much, All India Ophthalmological Society Scientific Committee, for giving me this opportunity to speak in this particular session and allowing me, along with Dr. Sunaina Malik, to conduct this session. I think in this era of COVID pandemic, most of us are sitting at home, then we will not be able to move around. And there were so many restrictions in this COVID pandemic. And because of that, we have thought of so many options. And one of the options was telemedicine. Like, you just can't sit at home and can't see your patients and advise your patients. So there were various platforms on social media, then internet. And you got connected with your patients. I think though physically you couldn't see your patients those days, I think this was the option available. And all of us took this particular challenge and tried to check our patients, treat our patients, talk to our patients, and give them satisfaction of treating also. And the same way, our profession, that is ophthalmologist profession, general ophthalmologist, that was also continued. Even the fees were collected from all of us. And all this was on online platform. And this concept of telemedicine was there in the past, but I think it was not flourishing up. But because of COVID pandemic, most of us thought probably this is the greatest and best platform. And this became new normal. And even if this COVID pandemic will pass away in future, probably we'll be able to continue with this telemedicine in future also. I remember one medical legal case when one doctor gynecologist given the advice to the pregnant lady and the relatives on telephone. The concerned doctor was in the conference and he described that particular situation to the relatives, everything. And then he prescribed some drugs, and afterwards there was some complication. The court blamed that doctor. Why have you misprescribed all those medicines on telephone? So that way it was not taken up in a good faith from court of law. So those days, telemedicine was not that promoted by court. But in this COVID pandemic, even courts, government guidelines and rules and regulations, everybody allowed us for telemedicine. But one new concept you must remember and you should remember, that is disclaimer. Whenever it is the telemedicine prescribed, it is not equivalent to the physical examination and treatment. But then there are certain limitations. And for that, medico-legally, you shouldn't be challenged by the patients and relatives. So some disclaimer must be put from your side. This is not 100% foolproof. This treatment is not 100% foolproof because you have not seen the patient physically. So with this disclaimer, you should give telemedicine and online treatment. So online medical checkup and consultations have already started in this COVID era. That is in the first wave. It has been continued in the second wave. And God knows if the third wave comes. And I think in the first wave, we were sitting in the homes, even hospitals. But then patients were reluctant to visit your clinics and hospitals. But then this particular COVID era, that was the option. And take this opportunity to project and promote our practice. And then we shouldn't say that this is not the good thing in COVID pandemic, but accept this with some sort of positivity. With this telemedicine, you are saving on so many things. That is the physical infrastructure, what you have in your clinics and hospitals. But then you have to invest on so many things, like your internets, then your softwares, then medical-legal aspects of those softwares, and whatever you are going to take to the patients, the documentation, and notes, and so many things. So whenever you are treating your patients by telemedicine and online consultation, most of the times you are casual. And that is the dangerous thing. So you shouldn't forget to keep your medical records. So medical record keeping is a must. It's a must. It's a must. Don't forget that. Because medical legal aspects, because of this teleconsultation, are also important. And this is, again, though online, it is the consultation. And I always tell to my colleagues, don't forget to charge, because again, this is the professional conduct. One more important thing you shouldn't forget, that medico-legal immunity has to be there. We are asking, because I am activist also, we are asking the government and their rules and regulations to be framed in such a way that whenever doctors are treating this patient in this COVID era, some sort of medico-legal immunity has to be given to doctors and medical profession. You cannot say that because the physically patient is not seen, such and such treatment was given to the patient, and then there was some deficiency in that. So medico-legal immunity has to be given to doctors and medical professionals by the government and court of law. Whenever you are examining the patients physically, if they are coming to you in your clinic, in your hospitals, I think protective gears, they are to be used. That is must for your direct consultations. And in this COVID pandemic, you must have heard, you must have read, you must have watched on television that government rules and regulations are there. Most of the times, they are changing every day. And you may not be knowing these rules and regulations while doing these online consultations and telemedicine. But then you must learn these rules and regulations regularly, because they are going to change your pattern of practice, your style of practice, the outcomes of your practice. So don't be reluctant about that. Make use of print and electronic media, television, social media. That way you can promote your telemedicine, because if you are sitting at your clinic, your hospital, or your home, maybe patients and relatives may not be knowing that you are available or not. So they should know that you are available for telemedicine and online consultations. So use of teleophthalmology. There are certain mobile apps, some companies. My previous speaker has talked about artificial intelligence. I think artificial intelligence is embedded in those scientific interpretations of those images, those diseases like diabetic retinopathy and so many things. Without real intelligence, I think those can be very well explained by artificial intelligence, and that also should be promoted. Whenever you are working as general ophthalmologist or some specialty ophthalmology practice you have been doing, you must involve family physicians, super specialists, general ophthalmologists, that is your colleagues. Because suppose you are a general ophthalmologist and you have to interpret about diabetic retinopathy, the vitreoretinal specialist must be taken into confidence. Same way, cornea consultant, spleen consultant, and so many super specialties in ophthalmology, because these are the related things in your practice and you must involve them. You must take this opportunity to promote your practice, to spread your practice, and horizons should be widened because of taking advantage of this telemedicine and online consultation. You can tackle the patient with all specialties which are available at and around. You must make use of optometrists, paramedics, for taking fundus and other photographs and sending them to higher centers for interpretation. Suppose you are sitting at one place, your subordinates and optometrists and paramedics, they can take photographs from various places. And those can be sent to super specialty tertiary centers for interpretation. So you have to involve our super specialists for interpretation and further treatment. And I think with these words, I'm not going to take much more of your time. This telemedicine, which was not promoted in the past, though it was done by a few of the surgeons, ophthalmologists, even government was trying to promote this teleophthalmology and this telemedicine business. And that time, that promotion was not that properly done. But now it is the need of the day. Need of this COVID pandemic, that all of us must learn about telemedicine and teleophthalmology. I think this is a great opportunity for our profession. With these words, I'll try to save 1 minute of my presentation and I'll end here. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Prakash, for saving 1 minute 20 seconds for us. And it was a very nice talk, because telemedicine